Hey, welcome back to my YouTube channel, guys. Today is part three of the differences between New Zealand and the US. So if you have not seen the first two parts of this, I will link them in the description below. So make sure that you subscribe if you want to see content like this. We talk about my journey from the US to New Zealand and what it's like and some of the differences living here. I offer consulting services if you're thinking about moving or traveling here, and I offer lots of cool things. So make sure that you check them out in the description below and subscribe. Here we go. The first thing that I want to talk about is the type of measurement. In New Zealand, they use the metric system. In the US, they use the imperial system. There's only a couple of countries in the whole world that use the imperial system. The only other countries that use it beside the US are Liberia and Burma. They're the only other ones that use the imperial system. So when you're coming to New Zealand or you're going to the US, just know that the types of measurements that you use are different. Now here's my handy tip, because I get this question: how do you adjust to the metric system? Like, how do you adjust when you're used to thinking, you know, in feet and miles and whatever and pounds? And it's called Siri. I just say, hey Siri, how many grams are in this? Hey Siri. So that's my little tip for you today. Because a lot of times I need to adjust when I'm baking or cooking and like my hands are all dirty. And so, you know, voice works the best. So that's my handy tip. Use Siri if you're traveling between the countries, because they use different systems and sometimes it's hard to just kind of calculate in your head. But yes, the US uses the imperial system, New Zealand, the metric system. Another big difference between New Zealand and the US is the term jelly. I get this asked to me all the time. What in the heck do you guys mean when you say you eat peanut butter and jelly? That's because in New Zealand, jelly, the jelly that we're talking about in the US is called jam. Jelly equals jam, okay? Because when you are saying jelly in New Zealand, it actually means like jello, okay? So that's why they don't understand how you're putting peanut butter and jello on a sandwich, okay? Because it doesn't work. So in New Zealand, jelly is jam, okay? But in the US, jam is jelly, and then like jelly is jello. Okay, see if you can figure that out. In New Zealand, your mail is delivered in these like cute little mail bikes, mail carts. I don't know what to call them. Comment below if you know the name for them. But they're like these cute little mail guys. You can like see them. It's not like an enclosed, it's crazy. They have mail carts and bikes here. In the US, they just have the mail truck, the US postal mail truck. And it just looks different. So just note, when you're in New Zealand, the mail truck looks really different. And it's like this bright red and yellow color. And they're cool, so check them out. In New Zealand, they have this interesting flavor called chicken flavor, like chicken chips or chicken salt. Like, yeah, you can buy chicken flavored potato chips and then chicken salt, and they put it on a lot of things. It's very, very common chip that they eat here. In the US, we don't have chicken chips or chicken salt. I mean, I think there is chicken salt, but they do have unusual types of chips that they don't have in New Zealand. So in the US, you'll find like Cool Ranch, Doritos, just like ranch in general is a very common flavor, or cheddar is a common flavor that you don't have here, because they don't really have cheddar cheese here. They do, but it's not as prominent in everything that they have in the US. So yeah, so they have chicken chips and chicken salt in New Zealand, but they have like ranch and cheddar and flaming hot everything in the US. And just so you know, Kiwis, New Zealanders, they don't like things hot. They like things plain. They definitely don't like them flaming hot. So just a tip for today. So chicken salt, chicken chips versus Cool Ranch, cheddar, and flaming hot. In New Zealand, they have a thing with heated towel bars. Heated towel bars. It's like in every house, and it's very common, and it's kind of sold as like, guess what? This place has heated towel bars. Like, what? I just remember noticing, it's almost a selling point to a house, a heated towel bar. And that's because the houses here are not heated well. And so things can get damp and moldy. And so it's kind of like to heat up your towel because it's hard to make it not wet because it's not dry enough in the house during the winter. And so heated towel bars are a thing in New Zealand that you don't see a lot in the US. But in the US, you will see things like essential oil diffusers. Like essential oils is like a big thing in the US. I've seen them here in New Zealand, it's not the same. They're like in every house in the US, like essential oil diffusers or like water purifiers. Or you'll have like your own water tanks in the US. You don't really have that here because the tap water in New Zealand is good and you can drink it. But in the US, you'll find that. So those are some odd things that you'll find in a house in the US. Whereas in New Zealand, yeah, heated towel bars. In New Zealand, they have Cheerios, which are flaming red colored sausages. Very commonly used as a party favor at kids' birthday parties. It's kind of a kid's food. And they're called Cheerios, like spelled like Cheerios. In the US, Cheerios is only a breakfast food. It's those same little round. They have them here in New Zealand, so New Zealanders know what Cheerios are, but for some reason, they have these really red, disgusting looking sausages that are also called Cheerios. I don't know why, so comment below if you know why, but I have a hard time eating them just because they are this really bright red color. So Cheerios in New Zealand is a sausage, Cheerios in the US, a breakfast cereal. Let's talk paper plates. In New Zealand, they don't really use paper plates, and they certainly don't use paper plates when they have guests over, unless it's like this huge, huge party and there's just no other way. But generally guests, or generally in general, they don't use paper plates. In fact, they're like really good with environmental issues and making things not plastic. In fact, my kids, when I first moved here, they went to a school and you couldn't wrap your stuff in plastic. It was like, they didn't get as many points or whatever because they were in an enviro school. And so you have to just have one of those containers that have the compartments so that you don't need to use any sort of wrapping and waste. So they're not wasteful here in New Zealand. They're much more advanced in that area, I would say, in the US in general. They've moved away from plastic. You can't even get plastic bags at the grocery store anymore. And they've just kind of eliminated plastic. And so they're very good about that. In the US, you will use paper plates. And I think that's because you could buy like 100 paper plates for like a dollar. But they don't have any problem serving it to guests. And they don't have problem using it like every day for normal dishes because it can't be bothered washing dishes. And so, yeah, Americans, they like to just throw things away. So they are way behind New Zealand in terms of being wasteful and in terms of eliminating plastic and using different sources instead of plastic. But in the US, they just love to throw things away. Well, this was part 3 of the New Zealand compared to the US, so you're not gonna wanna miss the first 2, so I will link them below. But make sure that you subscribe, and thank you for watching my channel, and thank you for joining me on my journey to New Zealand from the US.